If there were ever a time to use the hashtag Blue Book Life, it would be now.
Let's snuggle up with the 7th generation Mercedes-Benz S Class.
Oh, and snuggle we shall. Sure, we'll find space for criticism, but when reviewing an S Class, there are just so many neat features to discuss.
Case in point, the heated and ventilated front seats have 18 motors, 6 fans, and 10 massage functions with 2 intensity levels. We're going to use that hashtag quite a bit.
As expected, the interior is lush. The materials, textures, and arrangement ooze class, which is likely the least appealing way to say that something is classy. What's this? A headrest pillow? Cue that hashtag Blue Book Life. In back, it's more of the same. Comfort, quality, and space.
If I were a stern German executive, and God willing, one day I will be, this is how I would demand to be shuttled between meetings. Schnell!
On a quick practical note, the trunk is 13.8 cubic feet large. That is 1 cubic foot smaller than a Honda Civic's trunk. Weird! And back to the fancy stuff. Look at those screens! There's a 12.8-inch central touchscreen and a 12.3-inch digital gauge cluster.
As I've noted in other Mercedes reviews, the MBUX infotainment system is not the most intuitive I've used, but I do like the fact that you have multiple input methods. You can use the touchscreen, you've got these little controllers here on the steering wheel, and you can also use your voice. Hey, Mercedes! Hey, Mercedes!
How may I help you?
Destroy my enemies!
I'm sorry, can you say that again, please?
I only say it once.
If this were my car, I'd get used to using those voice commands, since the dash's minimal use of buttons means the alternative is managing vehicle functions through the touchscreen. For example, you have to dig into the menus if you want to adjust your lumbar support or activate the front seat massage functions. And good luck finding the audio settings while driving. Also, the latest S-Class no longer has an infotainment controller, meaning more smudges on the touchscreen. And with all that black plastic inside, you've already got enough smudges to deal with. So yeah, use your voice.
Hey Mercedes, turn on my seat heater. Hey Mercedes, what's the population of Stuttgart, Germany? Hey Mercedes, where's the volume knob?
A potentiometer is a 3-terminal resistor with a sliding or rotating contact that forms an adjustable voltage divider.
Way to distract from the issue, Mercedes.
Yes, I really would prefer a proper volume knob to this slider control. For precisely and quickly adjusting the volume, you still can't beat a knob.
And now let's bust out a lightning round of the S-Class's primo features.
Let's see, the base S500 luxury line features an air suspension, 6 USB-C ports, a 15-speaker Burmester audio system, this panoramic sunroof, a brilliant 360-degree camera system, wireless Apple CarPlay and wired Android Auto, wireless phone charging to match, a full range of active driver assist technology, pop-out door handles,
and soft closed doors, because these arms are made for typing, not for pushing doors closed. Atta girl.
That is an exceptional amount of luxury and technology on a base car, and oh wait, I've just seen the price tag. The least expensive S500 4MATIC sedan starts at nearly $110,000, not including destination charges. No, that is not cheap. Better show those soft touch doors again. Cool. Alright, how about we move on to the powertrain? All-wheel drive and a 9-speed automatic transmission are standard, as is a 3-liter inline 6-cylinder engine making 429 horsepower. You can also opt for a twin-turbo 4-liter V8. Here are the fuel economy figures for each.
Naturally, we're driving the V8. Let's see how it pulls from a stop. Oh, that is strong, but classy.
With either engine, you'll enjoy a 48-volt mild hybrid system dubbed EQ Boost, which, as I'm saying, it doesn't sound like something drivers would typically enjoy.
But compared to the intrusive shaking of many engine start-stop systems, the S-Class's velvety engine shutoff behavior is legitimately enjoyable. Yeah, smooth.
EQ Boost also allows the engine to occasionally shut down while cruising down the road. Where mild hybrid tech is concerned, EQ Boost is a neat one. As we're gliding along in comfort mode, I'll observe that the S-Class rides like it's in low Earth orbit.
I'm fairly certain there's a road down there, but based on the lack of vibrations, this could also be a simulation. Was Elon right?
choose sport mode, and the S-Class drives more like a car, with more strict body controls, while still redacting the road's harshness. I suppose we should also hit on the S-Class's exterior styling. In pictures, it looks conservative, but in person, I will say, it has presence. Here are some lingering shots so you can form your own conclusion. If the S-Class's six-figure base price doesn't make you balk, then I'm guessing a few grand more won't offend your sensibilities. With that in mind, you can upgrade your S-Class with the racier-looking AMG line or the V8-exclusive S580 Executive line that adds a three-screen rear seat MBUX interface, electrically adjustable rear seats, four-zone climate control, a rear steering system that'll make maneuvering in tight parking lots much easier,
and industry-first rear seat airbags that deploy from the front seat back to protect my precious face. Snow!
Other S-Class upgrades worth considering include a 3D gauge cluster, heated armrests, and a 30-speaker 4D audio system that includes subwoofers integrated into the outboard seats. The torso-thumping musical experience is kind of like a video game chair, but much classier. If you're thinking about buying an S-Class, what else should be on your consideration list? Obvious alternatives include the BMW 7 Series, Audi A8, Lexus LS, Porsche Panamera, maybe the Genesis G90, all of which are to varying degrees less expensive than the S-Class.
But let's not get bogged down by things like price and resale values. Can't we just behold the Mercedes-Benz S-Class for the technological, ultra-indulgent wonder it is? Yeah, that's the stuff.